Mark, you get to see reactions and counter reactions, some for, majority against it. Let's see if the Minister of Education will do something about it. On this discussion segment, we want to take a look at grassroots development, the impact of governance. It's like the grassroots have been sidelined according to some reports, according to some statements making round in the society. When I mean grassroots, the local government areas, the local government councils, to the world, to the units, you just name it. It's like the voices isn't heard. They are just, let me use the word, there. What are the causes of this? What can really be done to rejig the socio-economic and political activeness in government? So these are more we'll take a look at on this discussion segment. And of course, I have a human rights activist here with us in the studio, Leonard Atakmo. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Good morning, viewers.
Appreciate you coming. And of course, I have Obarayo Sahon. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, viewers. Good morning. Thank you so much, Wilson.
Yeah, he's a political analyst. And Honorable James Edoisiabo, welcome to the show.
Thank you, my brother.
All right. Okay. Let's put this show on the road. Grassroots seems to be so quiet in the scheme of things right about now, according to speculations and reports, if there's anything to go by. I want to start with you, Obarayo. What's your take so far on this?
Yeah, thank you so much, my brother. I think this area of grassroots neglect and grassroots development is one of the core area I think I can really dwell on, first of all, because as a grassroots person, we are there, we've been there, we are still there. I must tell you, our sins, the sins of the grassroots people today are caused by those that left the grassroots that never came back, are caused by those that came and climbed and used the grassroots, the collective, the oneness, the vote and the courage of the grassroots people, either moving down to local government as chairman or councillor, either moving down to House of Assembly, reps, senate and governor, never came back. That is the neglect and the suffering. But it must suffice you to know that, as we were discussing some time ago, that it all still boils down to neglect by the government itself. It also boils down to promises failed, promises not adhered to, as in, I will do this and nobody coming back to do it. Until 4 years' time, when their election is about 6-8 months' time, you see them coming back home to start doing road grading, street lighting, transformer issue, borehole, which is not the main core, I've been saying it, which is not the main thing that is the problem of the grassroots. My number one problem of this grassroots is to put food on the table. Because if as of today we still celebrate somebody that was giving constituency project money, coming to give us a borehole, a motorized borehole as the name may be, just to say, I have done well, and call on Wilson Omasha as a seasoned broadcaster to come cover the ceremony, to open a borehole for the grassroots people, I call that total failure. The reason why I say it's total failure for me is that the really problem of these people? As we see, as we can say now, we must be factual to ourselves. Water is God has diversified the water issue by making sure now that if you get focused on your job, we see in the next 2 years you can put borehole wherever you want to start staying. So somebody coming after giving constituency project money to tell you this is what I've done, this is what I've been doing, is failure. Okay. And my own conclusion on this first issue is that it's high time the grassroots people, because the grassroots 40%, 50% not educated, so they don't even know it. What they tell you if they sit down in their very comfortable zone is that we know how to get these grassroots people. On election day, we'll give them 5,000 per vote. They have no option than to koto, and they have no option than to follow us. So to me, it's high time the grassroots people know. If election day come, even you are collecting or not collecting, now know the person
that will not forget you. Are you getting it now? It's high time they know that it is better not to rise than to rise and fall. We now know those that has been setting us. We now know those that after they take money, they want to do this, even though they dodge for us not to see them. We know those that have represented us well.
All right, I'll come back to you now. You just anchor now. Now, let me come to you, Comrade Leon. I hope I can call you Comrade. He has spoken at length talking about the ignorant position of the grassroots and, of course, them being ravaged by poverty to the extent that 5,000 or even as low as 2,000, 1,000 can buy their conscience during election. What's your take so far on it?
Well, I think it is important to understand them. Who the grassroots people are in this context. First, it's important to underline the fact that the grassroots people are the people who are living in poverty. In this country, we have over 80 million Nigerians living under the less than $1 per day. These are people who are weak, who are vulnerable, members of the society. So they are the lowest rung of the ladder in terms of societal strata. And so the elites of this country, they take undue advantage of this class of people, knowing that they are at a disadvantaged position, in terms of the rung of societal ladder. And that being the case, we have had a situation in this country of years and decades of the grassroots people being used by the elites, being traumatized, and being put in a state of complete dehumanization, I put it that way. And this is because perhaps the grassroots people also allowed them to do that. Because again, there is this maxim that a people have the government or the government that they deserve. Yeah. If somebody have been fooling you, making mess of you for decades, and you have not been able to study, maybe your father, maybe your mother, your parents, grandparents, the elites, the fool, because once there is issue about capturing power, the elites, they come together, irrespective of their political divide. They could be PDP, APC, whatever name they call them. They come together recently you saw how the two leading political parties, they went to visit Mr. President. That is good enough. That is unity, right? Yeah. But again, the underlying factor there is that this class of people, the elites, they are together. That is the message, the grassroots people must understand. That when it comes to working together, they are together. Yeah? But it's only when they struggle for power that you begin to hear different names among them. But at the end of the day, it's the grassroots people that suffer from the policies, from the laws, from the decisions, from the order that they make at that level. Yeah. So the grassroots people now need to be organized. You must understand them. That is the way they operate. Because again, the elites, they have their agents that they send to the grassroots people during elections, for instance. Years ago, they will cow them with whatever. And then you believe them, you respond to them, you follow them. And then after casting your votes, after whatever, they still go back and do the same old things that they have been doing to you over the years. So it is now important for the grassroots people to take what? Their destinies in their own hands.
All right. I'll come back to you. Now, he talked about grassroots persons or people taking their destiny in their own hands. And of course, he talked about them getting the kind of government or governors they deserve. James, what's your reaction to that?
Thank you, my brother. I think the grassroots are not the problem. The people at the grassroots are not the problem. Because they are weak politically. They are weak economically, and they are weak socially. I think all things, we go back to our constitution to correct the ease in the grassroots. In our lifetime, we will never get it right. What do I mean by this? Grassroots are the people that live in the local government, at the ward and unit. And the government that will affect them is the local government. But for some time now, I don't think we have local government. For me, where I stay, I don't see or feel the impact of local government at all. I don't see their staff where, at all. And let us go back to where we had the problem, is the constitution. In section 7 of 99 constitution as amended, only caps that we shall have a democratic elected officer at the local government level, and the government will be the third tier of government and all. That's all. Till you go back to the first schedule, which that name, their function and their duty. And all the function mainly is tied to the local, to the state as well, assembly. So as you can see, that the state governors or the state government, they moderate. They've reduced the local government to a point that they cannot really affect the grassroots. And last time in this state, some council chairman, they assembled and said the state governor or the state government is not deducted from their council revenue. That week, I stumbled into one of them. We were talking. He told me, he said, what do I expect them to say? Their master, to say they take money from them? You can get it. So if they have autonomy, that local government is not under a state, just the way the state government is not under the federal. Listen, do you have federal ministry of state affairs? No. But in every state, you have ministry of local government and state affairs. So if the government is on their own, and the councillors, which has the power to impeach or to sack any chairman, and they have everything, they are autonomous, I think they will be effect at the grassroots. Because anytime the state governor or the state government takes some part of the money, and they will say no money, the council chairman will take his own. Since Oga has stolen, Oga cannot have boy, why do you also want ST? Before the last election, we are aware about Ego, Odo, and one local government that the chairman will be suspended and the panel will be instituted to go into it. But back to the election, those chairmen were asked to go back to office, and the report was never given to the public or whatever. So I think the problem is in our constitution, that autonomy will solve this whole problem.
All right. I'll come back to you. He talked about the problem of the grassroots is in the constitution, not the grassroots. But from what Leonard said, he talked about, it's like the grassroots, they're getting the government that they deserve. How can you juxtapose these two? Constitution or the grassroots?
Yeah. One is saying to it, the other one is saying doesn't. We are all still on the same page. Truly telling us that we, the grassroots people, is the government, we deserve what we have done. It's true. During the last election, I gave you a scenario of a woman that politically, she's senior to me age-wise, but politically she's like a daughter to me. That woman has been following my political ideology. So election money, I go to her place and say, "Mommy, let's go." The husband, sometimes two TV children, they go with me in the field. She helped me talk to the women, do our last mosquito campaign before going to the voting arena. The election before this one, yeah, there was one election before the presidential election. Yeah. As we were discussing, the woman came to me and said, "Leader," I said, "No, I've never failed you before." I said, "Yes, that's true." I said, "Hope no problem." I said, "No." He said, "You see those women, when they talk to them, they say, yes, yeah." "Somebody don't go give them 5,000. I said, "What do you know?" He said, I be not one go." He said, "But make you see, say, if me, my husband and the TV children, when I come, we collect this money, we'll get about 25,000-30,000. And you know, say, when they call, you come my house yesterday, I tell you, say, we never cook." I said, she told me as at yesterday that I gave her about 1,000 or 2,000 for soup. So she now told me, if I can see that, if for whatever mistake she would just make today and there's 25,000-30,000 going back home, there will be no need for her to go sell pure water at New Benin the next day. There will be no need for the husband to go look for job at Yahoo. So why don't just give me a nod? My brother, if I tell that woman not to go at that point, it's sinful. Because I don't have 30,000 to give to that woman. So how much want to, madam, take, follow your heart. And he said, no, she just wants a yes from me because she don't want me to be. I said, no, go. And when the woman voted against my party, because she's a very truthful woman, she showed it to me.
before she was, she showed it to me, to ask him, my conscience, though not free, but there will be food on the table. So you can still see that I will not quarrel with that woman, number one, but also quarrel with her because there will be continuity. That soup will finish within 1 week. And you start selling pure water again in this rain, sun, everything for the next 4 years. But if we had come as a, if the grassroots, all of us have said, this one will want to change this government. For the first time, let's unite. Let's reject their money at that point. Reject it at that point to say, let's just do it for one day. And we want this total change. My brother, the issue that my senior brother here, the comrade, has said, that you would not see that, then we would have changed our destiny ourselves. Coming to the one my brother said about the constitution, who writes the constitution? Is it the grassroots people? They sit down in the very conducive place to write our constitution for us. Which constitution are we using? Constitution that was a decree, and we, the people of Nigeria, who was the we? There are 2 to 4 people. Are you getting it now? It's deciding the future of over 200 million people. I was telling one of my friends that they made SSC, and this, I said, if only you know the problem you don't have with this your new position. And the boy smiled. I said, you will not know it. The boy was calling me. I said, boss, are you telling me? I said, yes, the problem counselors are suffering, so to start suffering now. After this rain, just this rain now, because of this rain, they will not come. By 10-11 today, the SA that the salary will not be up to 100,000. We have, let's say, 13, 14, 20 something visitors, depending on the area he lives. This one, the governor said, you must go back to your place. So think of the one that stays in New Benin, Igbesama area, where you have huge amounts. He needs to buy drinks in the morning. He needs to cook. And how much is the money? But our House of Assembly, House of Rep, senators that blow throat all over the world, that collect billions before impeachment, that does everything before they do anything. How often do we see them back again to the grassroots?
All right.
They kneel down for. They knelt down for before the election.
Okay.
So, my brother, all these issues still boils down to our guy at the top that don't want this to fall down well.
Okay, now you just hold on now. Now, he's heaping the blame finally from his own anchoring, that is the man at the top. Is it the man at the top that is really causing all these palaver wahala, so to speak, for the grassroots?
Yes, there is a connivance at that level, you know, by the elites. They come together. They are just a few in number in the society. Yeah? But they have control of security. They have control of power. They have control of economy. And so they use all of that to dominate the people at the grassroots, year in, year out. So long you keep quiet and acquiesce to whatever they are doing to you. So it subsists. And then they want to remain at that level, unless you overthrow them. Look at what's happening in Venezuela. Venezuela is an oil-producing country like Nigeria. If you go to the streets of Venezuela, you will not see anyone not tarred. The amenities are there, but just a little difference. Maduro is on fire, and the citizens are asking him to quit, to live there. And every day, there's a sustained protest against the administration of Maduro. And so, if we want things to change in this country, I take your mind back to during the era of President Goodluck Jonathan, when he decided on January 1 to increase the price, the pump price of petrol. You saw the kind of response that came from labor, from civil society, from grassroots people across the country. People willingly came out to protest against that policy. Yeah, what happened? Gradually, government reversed, government went back, and then said, okay, let us still continue to have subsidy, you know, at so level. Now, what happened thereafter? So, but that is the kind of, you know, response we expect that grassroots people should be taking. You do not keep quiet all the time, you know, when these elites are messing up with your right, your fundamental right. You know, you just keep silent. And if you keep silent, you will just perish in the air. They kick your ass, you say, yes, sir.
Watch your language now. Watch your language. Watch your language. Yeah, watch your language.
You say, yes, sir. And then They come for you, they come for your neighbor, you say, we have been talking to him and my neighbor. The next time they come for you, and you don't have anything to respond to. So it is important that the grass people get organized to ensure that the situation, for instance, poverty in this country. Why should Nigerians at the grassroots be subjected to this kind of level of poverty that we're experiencing today? It is because we have kept silent over the years, and we really do not push for our rights, economic rights, social rights, economic rights. Yeah? So it's not about constitution thing, my brother. You know, the constitution is there. If we enforce the constitution the way even it is today, we enforce the laws that we have, the policies that we have today, there'll be food on the table for the common man. But the same people who crafted the constitution, who crafted the laws and the policies, they will also be the ones to circumvent it. How many big men are in prison today?
All right.
How many big men are arrested for crimes they commit in this country? Mm. How many? The elites that we're talking about. Even those that you caught with billions and billions of dollars in their homes, in their bedroom, in the cemetery, in their
water tank and the rest.
How many are in prison today?
No.
Okay, the common man who stole fowl is in prison. The one that stole a bicycle, the one that protested, is he even in detention and he has not even been presented for trial.
Yes. All right, I'll come back to you. But from what both of them just said, they are still heaping the blame also on the elite. But Paul, like I said, the reason why the elite, so to speak, in quote, during elections are taking the grassroots for a ride is because there's no unit in the grassroots. A little drop of cash can just make them have their own thought pattern. These are rate to favor the political parties or the elite. How true is that assertion?
Oh, my brothers, they are not far from the truth. And I think where we are missing it in our discussion here is we are saying the same thing but in a different way. The topic I understand we are talking about this morning is grassroots development. Yes, I'm talking about it because why I refer to a constitution, because constitution is the framework or the instrument that control the elite that come down to the grassroots. On the issue of voters taking money, like what my brother have said, I'm not blaming the voters. No, because like you said, somebody that will sell pure water, I guess for you to get 3,000 naira as a profit, it will take 1 year. And just 1 day. So we are saying the same that our leaders or the elite. My point I'm interested on the question is that if question is well defined about the local government, at least the way council is run that we see now will be different. It is true that if we have a council chairman on seat, that councillors can even impeach them. Are you aware? Whether they are wrong, whatever they have against the chairman, they will take it to the assembly, and the chairman has millions of naira to throw around. And the house of assembly say, "Councillors, you go back and it can be impeached and so." So I think our constitution is the problem, because if all of us can hold our chairman accountable, I think the impact on grassroots will be more visible. Yes, because the reason some chairmen are not performing is that nothing we the masses can do, because until governor say I should go, I will not go. You get it? Nothing the council can do till governor say I will go. But by the time that it is not local, the governor that hire and fire the chairman, it is the people. By the time that is that if the people at the grassroots now begin to protest, the chairman has not shown them to go, then there will be more impact from the council to the people. Because now, whether the folks protest or not, until the governor say, "Chairman, you wrongly, you are sacked." So this is the problem that why I refer back to the constitution. Come to the people. Any man that is drowning in the sea, whether the wood is iron or tons or whatever, it will hold it for survival. So after survival, they began to treat the wound. That's the true we find our people now. When is election, people are bringing money because they are hungry. They are hungry. So they want to, because they know that whether they vote or not, I love what Kwame said earlier, that the people are the top, whether party A, party B, they are the same. And it's true. That is the reason the rest of people are taking money. Okay, after all, whether we vote without money, they will still go back and do what they want to do. Let's just take our own. But I think we, the people at the grassroots, we need to wake up at this time. Since we'll be taking money, it's not making any impact. So let us start taking money from them.
Stop taking money from them?
Yes.
All right, I'll come back to you on that. It says stop taking money from them. Because after talking about the people, talk about the local government chairman, and of course autonomy. But I just struck a chord. Stop taking the money. Do the right thing. They can have a change.
No, I will not support that.
Come on!
You see, we shall continue. No, I don't lie. You see, we shall continue to take their money because this is not their money. These people, we are saying, they started from the grassroots. They were once with us here. Now, the way we see it, we dream together, we gather money to pay. We all started together. They left and they didn't come back again. That is just the truth. So, if you come back and tell me about this is 50,000 for your election day, I will say, thank you, my brother. God bless you. Is it give me more? Because it's our own collective issue. It's not left. What I want my brother to say is, make sure your conscience, my conscience, nobody, no amount of millions can change it. So if I take your money and tell you I'm going to, I will not also tell you I'm going to vote for you. You're giving me that and I say, thank you. But when I put my hand on the party, we should no longer vote on party line. I'm not talking, we should forget about this is party A, party B. I start to be corrected. The last time I checked, I'm a card-carrying member of Ashok Congress of Nigeria, APC. So I know what I'm telling you. This time, if your party gives you somebody you know that will not come back to the grassroots, vote out the person. It should be plain and clear because we've suffered a lot. Local government autonomy should be number one. In saying the truth, it should be also the House of Assembly members. You will they support it? No. The bulk of this issue to me is I'm not just talking about local government councillors. No, those people are mainly they cover the. I just gave you an example of the SAs now that the governor just appointed. I get it now. Those SAs now they are carrying now. Is larger than so many of them because you will hear somebody they attend social activities on weekends, on weekend basis, social activity Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, at least spending 2, 3, 4, 5 thousand on each just to make sure governance continues at that level. Tell me, where are our senators? Where are our House of Rep members on this same issue? These people, the money they carry, so local government chairman don't even see that. I'm not sure you are aware. I was privileged to have worked in National Assembly, so I know the billions moving year from one to that place. If they come here and tell you our salary is not up to 1 million, answer them and say yes. Then tell them what you collect quarterly in 3 months. If your worker, a senator, a serving Nigerian senator, does not have anybody in his office that is paid 100,000, the least person in his office that the federal government pays is a minimum of 115,000, 120,000 for the least. Then the highest, if the senator has a position, maybe a minority or a majority leader, the person will also have a chief of staff that his salary is over 400,000 naira. So tell me, if this one works with the people he works with, how much is his own salary? They come here, they paint issues, they will stop money back for the election. After giving to leaders will not sit there in their parlor, AC blowing them with cup of tea, and Carol will say, leader, this is your chair, this is this new Prado Jeep for you, and you now say, Wisdom Masha is the next, go and deliver it. Deliver what and deliver who? Right. Until this person, the next people come from the grassroots,
we are the grassroots who will not carry again.
All right, it's all about the grassroots this morning. Of course, impact of government. You getting to hear the way they feel about what is really happening. It's like the tail isn't that palatable. It isn't that sweet. But in this contest, who do you think should be the one to determine the destiny of the people in the grassroots? Grassroots, local government, the council, the units, you just name it. That is all. Taking a look at this beautiful morning on this morning on ITV. Now, he talked about autonomy. Will autonomy really solve all this?
I laugh because because I mean, it was just the amendment that they did to the 1999 constitution that brought about this state local government joint account that you're talking about. Otherwise they were joint autonomy. So we're only going back to what it was before. At that time, was it better? If we could do that comparison, the comparative analysis, at that time, was it better? You see, because even the council chair is either a part of the elite or agent of the elite. You know, so they work together, they connive. Do you know that even the way we are talking about now, amend all the constitution, give the autonomy, that one big politician will come from Abuja and fix all the local governments chair in Edo State,
the council
under state. The autonomy, whatever you call it, with his money, with his big bag of money. So it's about governance, about good governance. Let it go through the grassroots. How many council chairmen will come every morning, every month, and tell the people of his local government that this is the amount I received from Abuja, this is what we collected from internal revenue of this local government, and this is amount we are giving to water, this is amount we are giving to education, this is the amount we are giving to health, this is the one we are using to do feed our roads, the third health center, this is the amount we are allocating to that, and this is the balance, this is what we are giving to salary. How many local government chairmen will come and do that? So it's about good governance, because if we have good governance coming from the top, that's why people are also talking about devolution of power. Because, for instance, as we speak now, if you talk about constitutional amendment, it's not just about local government autonomy. It's a whole gamut, of amendments that you need to make. Because power is now concentrated in
Abuja,
at the federal level, at Abuja. So that is where it is happening. Ebona, Kwato. That is where it's happening. So if you like, plan to a council chairman every week, at the end of the day, what gets to the
common man,
the hoi polloi of the society, the grassroots man, what is getting to him? Why should federal government be, handling something like education? You want to build primary school? It is the federal government that will come from Abuja to come and tell us in Edo State how to build primary school. They come with UPEC. Why should you do that? So devolve powers to the, states and LGs, and then also devolve the revenue to them. And then you also think, how do we generate the revenue to service this? So what has happened over the years is that they pile the money up there in Abuja. They take all their time to appropriate it to, and then the money go to different directions. A few pockets, just corner all of that money. And today we hear it. All the money they appropriate for this. At the end of the day, you don't find it. Now people talk about law enforcement, for instance. People talk about underfunding of police. Is that really the issue? We have seen some former IGs that, they were also stacking money on water tanks. Where has he called the sergeant, the small policeman there? They are grassroots, but the small man there in the police. He's not having anything.
He won't issue.
He has to come by issue himself.
Okay.
How would such a man enforce law in his own?
Why will not collect it?
You are fighting corruption.
All right, now when we return, we'll come to James. We'll talk about, is it autonomy or accountability that really see the local government or the grassroots through? After this update for 9:30, we'll continue with this discussion. Do stay with us.
Thank you so much for my way. For the news update for 9:30 is all about grassroots development, the impact of government. That is what we're taking a look at on this discussion segment. And I told our viewers that I'll come to you, James, because from what Leonard said, he said, look, it's not all about autonomy. What practice autonomy, did you see any change? And the answer is like, you know, very, very big. Is it autonomy now or accountability?
Thank you, my brother. You cannot get accountability when you don't have a full autonomy at the grassroots level. Yes. I know we'll be saying that for what we have now, what I will be getting. I'm looking at a situation that the council chairman will not be tied to the effort spring of the governor, where the people that he govern can hold him for an account. For instance, if in the local government, if all the wards mobilize to say, chairman, you are not doing well, I think there will be impact, the chairman will affect the impact, the pressure, than when that. What we have now that he believe that till the governor sack me, whether the people that I govern say no, I will not go. So autonomy in the sense that they will not have excuse that is the state governor taking their money and all that. Autonomy I'm talking about is that the 10 councillors or the 12 councillors with their bylaw or their law can impeach any chairman, unlike what we have now. So, on the issue of accountability, that is the framework of law. If the question specify it, that when a chairman, the truth is that what we have in our constitution and in our law that governs the council is nothing. It's nothing, my brother. It's nothing. So, it's difficult for any person at the grassroots now to even go to court and say, a chairman, we want to know how much you receive and how much you are spending. So, autonomy, we are saying, it's not just give them money at all. It goes about give them guidelines and framework how to operate and how to what manage the local government affairs. So on the issue of accountability, that is a Nigeria problem. Whether at the federal, state, or local government level, that's a problem. So I have not seen any governor in this country, that say this month we receive social allocation, and this time the agenda is this how much we spend. No, so it is hard time that we, the masses, also begin to demand from our leaders to give us a report. Not during election, they bring salt, pepper, and onions. No, it's hard time that we should mobilize.
Okay. All right. Now, gentlemen, we have 1 minute each to summarize. We're close to 15 minutes before the news we've been talking. We started this discussion at about 9, and it's a little bit to 10, almost an hour. We have 1 minute each to really summarize grassroots development, impact of governance. What advice do you have for the people in the grassroots and, of course, the government of the day? 1 minute each. I want to start off with you.
Yeah, thank you so much, my brother. My people in the grassroots, it's high time we should forget about where we are coming from and without knowing where we are going to. Election, if we don't go away, I told you, we meet us here. We should use our thumb and our voters' card to this time choose the person we know, not party issue. So it's not left because these same people that the elites, the owner of the society, they control the party structure, but they don't control how we vote. So since we are the one that controls how we vote, we should at this time stand in unison. I love what is going on in some areas now that people are no longer talking about politics. They are not talking about, oh, we know this man. He can really deliver us.
All right.
Begging this man, come and help us have.
Okay,
thank you. It's far better.
Thank you so much, Abare. Leonard, what's your take? 1 minute, please.
Yeah, beyond elections, I also feel that there is need for us to ensure good governance, transparency, and accountability in government. Yeah, right. And it's also important for grassroots people to hold those in authority accountable to them, because that is the only way, you know, they will be able to get out of the current situation that the grassroots people find themselves in this country.
Well, thank you so much, Leonard. James, a minute.
My own position is that we should stop taking money from the politicians.
Because is saying no way.
Take money from them. Listen, last all election, right. Where I was voting, as I give you money, they have agents how to monitor your vote. So if you don't take money, you can vote your conscience. So when, there's no way you take money from them and you're not be controlled who to vote for. In my own submission, let us stop taking money from them and vote the person you think can deliver. That's my
solution. Well, thank you so much, gentlemen. They agree to disagree and disagree to agree, but it's all about the grassroots. Don't forget where you're coming from, and don't also forget where you project yourself to go to. Mind you, you have to remember where you're coming from. You have to see where you are going to. Grassroots, the powers of the nation is in your hands. Depending on the way you choose to use it, that'll depend also on how you will be governed. Gentlemen, I really appreciate your wonderful analysis once more.
Thank you, sir.
Hope we'll have some other time to really do this again. Well, tomorrow, Sunday Duke Okosu will be around to continue with this week's edition of This Morning on ITV. And all of us here in the studio, we're saying have a wonderful Sunday. Bye for now.